In this example, we are required to find the current flowing through the battery and charge on capacitor in a steady state. In this example, here we can say that this 3 ohm resistance is connected in parallel with the 6 ohm resistance because both of the terminals of these two resistances are connected to each other. And in this situation, the circuit can be redrawn like this. This is the 4 ohm resistance. This is a capacitor of 2 microfarad. And here this 3 ohm is in parallel with 6 ohm. Then the equivalent resistance will be 3 into 6 by 3 plus 6. That will be 2 ohms. So here we can connect this 2 ohm resistance, which is the parallel combination of 3 and 6 ohm. And this is another resistance 4 ohm which is connected to a 24 volt battery. Now in this situation, here we can see in a steady state no current will flow through this 2 microfarad capacitor. So in this situation the only current will be flowing through these two resistances which is 6 ohm in series combination. So the current flowing can be directly calculated as 24 by 6, this 4 ampere. That is the current flowing through the battery, which is one answer to the problem. And if the current is 4 ampere, we can calculate the potential difference across terminals A and B. VAB can be written as, this will be 2i, that will be 8 volt. The same will be the potential difference across 2 microfarad capacitor because no potential drop will be there in this 4 ohm resistance as no current is flowing in this branch. So this is the potential drop across this 2 ohm or this is the potential difference across 2 microfarad capacitor. So here we can calculate the charge on capacitor in a steady state is this Q can be written as CVAB. That can be written as 2 microfarad multiplied by 8 volt. That will be 16 microcoulomb. That is the another answer to this problem.